AI industry is expected to see another year of explosive growth in 2025. But our analyst, Chris Markoch, is here to talk about three stocks that are really becoming useful in the healthcare industry that could see a lot of growth in the new year. So, Chris, before we get to your stock picks, let's just talk about these AI companies. There's so many different tech companies out there, but really the ones that seem to be finding success are the ones that are finding a way to make AI useful for everyday problems.
I've been talking about it for a while. It's being called AI 2.0, and the goal is that you've got to figure out, now that we've built all these data centers or are in the process of building them, and companies are figuring out that they can create AI applications, what can they do with these AI applications that are going to actually make them useful, that are going to make them more than just a nice to have or just kind of an enhanced Siri or Alexa for a consumer. And one area where that's really being noticed is in the healthcare field. The three companies that we're going to be talking about are technology companies, but they're technology companies that are figuring out how to deliver AI for that specific industry.
Absolutely. Now, before we get to your pick of three AI stocks that are really taking off in the healthcare industry, take a look at this free report that lists seven AI stocks for beginner investors, a way to really help your portfolio take off. Scan the QR code or click the link in the description to check out that free report on MarketBeat.com. All right, Chris, let's get to your picks. What is the first stock that you're looking at that's seen a lot of growth in healthcare?
Okay, so my first pick is a stock that everybody will be familiar with, and it's Alphabet. They've got a really big lead in this area with their Google Health platform. It's the idea that it has tools inside of it that help hospitals do ultrasound and breast cancer screening. It's also got a series of their own large language models that stem from other products they have. And then they also, through Google Health, they have something called Open Health Stack, which is a tool for developers to use so that they can create other digital health solutions. And so the whole point here is Alphabet's just got a big lead. It's a stock that some people believe is a little bit undervalued right now, although the current price is pretty close to the consensus price, but JP Morgan Chase has a price target on it of 232. That's going to be over 20% more than where it's trading at right now.
Yeah, and of course, like you said, this is a stock everyone's familiar with
Yeah.
and probably uses every single day. But this area of growth that you're talking about for Alphabet, this really isn't that consumer face of Google. This is more a specialized section of Google Health, correct?
Correct. I think it will be more consumer facing over time. I think the goal is that they want to make it so that patients will have access to the tools similar to what you get with Apple Health and different things like that. So consumers do have some visibility to it, but the primary goal here is to help physicians help and now help developers develop these tools in such a way that it's just going to become a regular part of our lives.
So Google is one AI company that's seen some growth in healthcare. What's your second pick for AI companies that are really making some advancements in healthcare?
Sure. The pick here is Medtronic. We've talked a lot about Intuitive Surgical on the channel, and Medtronic is a competitor of Intuitive Surgical in terms of the robotic surgical arm. But one thing that really stood out to me with Medtronic is they're using AI to help hospitals and physicians analyze large volumes of data to diagnose and predict outcomes for patients. And to me, this is a really fascinating element of AI. The whole idea here is to say, what can we do to say to try and figure out why treatment A worked well with patient B, but maybe it didn't work as well with patient C, and how can we figure out what treatment might work best for them based on aggregating all this data, which is what AI probably does best right now, is just it's a great way to aggregate this data and form and try to decipher patterns and predictive for outcomes. And this is a big deal for this area of customizable or personalized medicine that we're moving into. And I think Medtronic is really on the forefront of this.
Yeah, it's definitely gaining some traction as an idea,
Right.
something more consumers want to see more of too. So
Right.
what does that mean for the stock price? Where is this company at right now, and what are analysts thinking it could do in the next year?
The stock's down fell about 11.5% in the last 3 months of 2024. But some of the reason for that was because the Federal Reserve came in and they kind of threw cold water on this idea of a lot of interest rate cuts in 2025. And Medtronic is a good part of Medtronic's business is the medical device business. So people are concerned that maybe there's not going to be as much sell through to hospitals with their medical devices because of higher interest rates. However, that makes this a dip buying opportunity. The stock's trading at a point where it got a little bit of support in the late summer at around the price it's at right now. It may drop a little bit more, but I see there being a pretty good upside to the stock in 2025.
All right, let's move on to your third and final pick of an AI company that's really making some great advancements in healthcare.
It's Stryker. This is a name that might be more familiar to some investors. The ticker symbol is SYK. It is, not surprisingly, a competitor of Medtronic, and it focuses on some of the same areas that Medtronic does in terms of medical devices and areas like that. Where I was looking at Stryker is, right now Stryker looks fairly attractive to me as a dividend grower in the next couple of years. If you look at the dividend yield, it's not really that impressive. It's about 0.93. Medtronic, for example, has a yield of 3.5. So some investors may say, well, Medtronic's obviously the better dividend stock. Well, yield's kind of a funny way of looking at that. A thing I really like about Stryker is they've been growing their dividend very aggressively in the last 3 years. They've been growing at a rate of about 9%. So right now that puts it about 84 cents per share on an annualized basis. I'm looking, the company is on track to increase that again this year. I would think that 9% is another very reasonable target for them. And I think you could, in fact, it wouldn't surprise me if they even increased that a little bit. So Stryker is one of those stocks that I look at and say, you kind of buy it for the dividend now, and you're looking at maybe the growth coming in later.
So it's a great dividend stock pick. How about where the price is at right now? Is it a bargain stock right now? Is it trading fairly high at the moment? Where can people get into the stock at a good point?
Now may be about the time you want to get into it. It's about 12% below the consensus price. It's dropped about 8% in the last month of the year. That's not surprising. Most stocks did. Just in correlation with the rest of the market. So I think this is a good opportunity to look at buying the dip on Stryker and take advantage of, again, like I said, there's about a 12% upside in the stock price, and you're going to get in on this dividend that's been growing aggressively.
Well, some good information for our viewers today to consider when they're looking at their newest stock picks for 2025. Thanks for your time today, Chris, and thank you for joining us. You can find more on Chris's article if you want to read the full story. And as always, thanks for joining us and happy investing.